Hello, everybody. Welcome to another segment of Mic Drop here on the Comedy Trap House channel. I am your host, Mike Mendez. Today with me, I got Cam.
Yerp.
And I got Rome.
Yerp, yerp, yerp.
And we are back doing another bracket video. But this time, it's a little different. We're not doing a single artist or producer. We're doing an arrangement of songs that we could consider, you know, the term one-hit wonders. Mm-hmm. Now, I know some of you are going to say, that guy's not a one-hit wonder.
Yeah.
That guy's not a one-hit wonder. I know his song. Like, that don't matter.
We might be talking about the impact of the song. Like
the one impact that this song has made specifically is better than anything else that they made.
Gotcha.
And no disrespect to the artist.
Yeah,
you know,
for sure.
But
for sure.
I mean, you know, numbers don't lie.
Numbers don't lie.
Women lie, men lie.
And here's the thing here at Comedy Trap House. We could also be completely wrong.
Mm-hmm. That's very true. We consider ourselves professional, but we're nowhere near. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
It is all take all this with a grain of salt. This is our humble opinion.
Yeah, pretty much.
All we can really say about us is that we love music.
Yep.
We love all aspects of it. So we love talking about it. We want to discuss like which one of these is a little better, you mm-hmm. know. But I think we should keep that in consideration. This is what we think.
For sure.
Yeah,
for
yeah,
sure.
yeah. This isn't sure. like we'll take part like global impact yeah, and stuff yeah, yeah. like that. But global overall, impact. Yeah, you know some of these songs change the world.
Oh, for sure.
Some of these songs change
oh, yeah,
the world.
For sure.
One man can change
some
the world.
Some change my world.
Yeah. yeah? Do you see one on here that okay, well oh, yeah. hopefully when we get there we'll discuss it. again. Broke it down into sections, you know, my world famous brackets here.
Mm-hmm.
We got the Vanilla Ice section.
Okay.
Look at that fly jacket.
I mean, yeah.
That's fly.
It's racist.
It's racist, yeah. but it's fly. Then we got the Cisco section
Come
with
on,
the
man.
Wyatt hair. That's going to be exciting.
That's going to be exciting.
We got the Mark Morrison holding a compass, I believe.
Mark Morrison, yeah.
Yeah, he's trying to find out the direction of his career and where it went. And then we got the Rocky section, the Survivor section.
Gotcha.
You know, broke it down.
You know what song I thought about was Careless Whisper, but
that's definitely not.
But
a
it's not a one hit
George Michael. Put some respect.
I was thinking about big songs. I was like, damn, that's a huge song.
That is a huge song. You know,
that's incredible.
Yeah, that's incredible.
I was watching a documentary about him, about George Michael, and he came up with the saxophone line in his head
mm-hmm.
and couldn't and like hired the best saxophone player in
and
Europe.
He didn't play it.
Didn't play it.
Yeah, and then I think they went with
some session, some regular session.
Yeah, player. The guy came in and did it, and he was like, actually, that's what I wanted.
Yep. Just random, some random dude came in and was like, "That, yep, that's it.
Yeah.
Hey, when you find it, you find it.
That's it.
All right, let's get started here. We're going
to
start right there at the top left with the song that basically created Def Row Records. And
that's hilarious.
And if you don't know that story, maybe we can get into that another
a wild
time. But
story.
We got Ice Baby against Tag Team's Whoop. There it is.
Damn.
They both have a significance in my life. Like, I was a huge Ninja Turtles fan,
mm-hmm.
so I love Vanilla Ice. Could that go Ninja, go oh, all
that.
That was Ice, Ice Baby. I remember
he got close with that one, huh?
I remember as a kid, I loved that song so much, and seeing them in Ninja Turtles, I begged my aunt, buy me this album.
Mm-hmm.
So I remember buying the album that had Ice, Ice Baby on it. I would play it all the time and do that dance.
Yep.
Then, whoop, there it is. My first recollection of music as a child is like Miami bass.
Mm-hmm.
So all this booty shaking, rump shaking, whatever you want to call it, music has a special place in my heart, because that's one of my first recollections of music, hearing all that down in Miami.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, it's pretty tough.
I didn't know Tag Team was like a Miami one. I thought it was like Atlanta. But
no, it is, but I'm just saying
that
Miami bass sound.
Oh, yeah.
So
my dad used to play that a lot, mm-hmm. and then I too connected with Ninja Turtles through the Ice Ice Baby, so mm-hmm. it's going to be an interesting one.
Yeah. Ice Ice Baby was like, by the time I like realized what it was already cheesy to me.
Gotcha.
Because like I'm a little bit, just a tad bit younger.
Mm-hmm.
But on the way here, I listened to all these songs on the way here. And Ice Ice Baby, like that intro, with the hi-hat.
It's hard.
That Queen bass line. that shit's so hard.
I guess we got to listen to a little snippet
right,
of both.
Stop. Collaborate and listen.
That's
back with a brand new edition. Something, man. Come on, man. Put respect on Van Winkle. Robert Van Winkle. That shit's saucy, nigga.
Yo, VIP.
YouTube's never gonna let you get away with this.
Let's kick it.
That's it.
Ice, ice, baby.
All right, stop, collaborate and listen. Ice is back with a brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly. Flow like a hawk through daily and nightly. Will it ever stop? Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights and I'll glow. To the extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up the stage and rock and jump like a candle. Dance.
Come on, Vanilla.
Yeah, come on, yeah. Man. No, Winkle.
It hypes. It's hype.
That shit hard.
But also.
I mean.
Party people!
Yeah. 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 Miami.
That bass that's like.
That's me, DC.
That shit hard,
and my
too.
Man, Steve Rowland. We're kicking the flow.
We're kicking the flow.
And it goes a little something like this.
Tag team. Back again.
Check it directly. Hey. Let's begin. Hey. Party on, party people. Let me hear some noise. DC's in the house. Jump, jump, rejoices. There's a party over here. A party over there. Hey. Wave your hands in the air. Shake the
dairy. Yeah.
These three words mean you're getting busy.
Whoop, there it is.
Hitman.
Whoop, there it is. Whoop, there it is. Oh, man, that's whoop, a hard one. They got the shakalaka, shakalaka. That shit hard.
Based on the feeling, how you guys feeling?
See, I don't know. Wait, what are we going by? What's the biggest hit, or just what we just prefer?
Well, and this one is gonna have to be both. Yeah, like, what you prefer? That's tough. Damn, man.
I'm picking last.
All right. I think this one. I think we should just go off of feeling.
Okay.
Like,
okay.
How we feel.
Okay.
This is our video. If you want your, make your own video. But for us, I think this is what's more important. And I think I got mine. But Rome, you got something to say?
I'm picking last.
You came strong off top. So I had to. Yeah, I don't fuck with you like that. But it's I'm gonna go ice baby.
Ice baby. Yeah, okay.
I'm gonna go ice baby.
Damn.
I'm picking last.
You picking last? All right. I think Woomp, There It Is like one of those LimeWire songs where I would download it and put it on a mix, so I would hear it all the time.
Follow your heart.
But then Ice Ice Baby is just like, I know every word to Ice Ice Baby, and I don't think I've ever like actively listened to it.
Gotcha.
And I think I enjoy it like that. So I think I'm gonna go Ice Ice.
But then Ice Ice it is.
You got to let us. Tell us. Maybe you changed your mind.
What you were thinking?
They both hold a special place in my heart. I know. But I guess I gotta go with Ice Ice Baby because it's this that tied to the movie, tied to me begging for that album. I really wanted that.
I think we did hard. You did a good job. There it is here at the Trap House.
Ice Ice Baby was the bigger smash.
Oh. True.
I'm telling you, that shit created Death Row. The whole reason Tupac and all them were, well, maybe not Tupac,
but
you know what I'm saying. All right, now we got two songs that are telling you what to do. You got Achy Breaky Heart, Smash. Billy Ray played this shit, I think, 5 times in a row in a concert one time.
That's crazy.
Killed it every time. Mm-hmm. And has a little dance to it. They made a Spanish version of this where I hear that shit at Mexican parties, like family parties.
What's the name of it?
It's just same shit, just in Spanish.
But I'm saying, can you say it?
I'll find it. I'll play it later. But they have like a little like swing dance to it. Mm-hmm. Don't break my heart. And then Cupid Shuffle.
Black barbecue and family.
Oh yeah,
that's without ever being invited to the barbecue. That's kind of what I assume.
No, you've been invited by now. You've been here long enough.
Yeah. If you have a barbecue in Southern California,
I've never been invited to the barbecue.
I got you. Okay, got you. Not metaphorically.
Not metaphorically.
I got you. Yeah.
Literally.
Yeah. let's see. Let's take a look. You know, Achy Breaky Heart, too. There's some cold lyrics, too, in the beginning.
I know. That shit feels country.
I can smell the bar.
Hey.
Oh, you can tell your friends just what a fool I've been, and laugh and joke about me on the phone.
Hey, okay.
You can tell my arms
to
go back into the phone.
Whoa.
You can tell my feet to hit the floor.
Ooh.
Or you can tell my lips to tell my fingertips they won't be reaching out for you no more.
Hey.
Don't tell my heart.
Uh-huh.
My achy breaky heart.
Talk shit.
Just don't think he'd understand.
Hey, he was talking shit. Hey, he was talking shit. I ain't mad at it.
I can smell the bar. It looks like Claremont Lounge. Oh, yeah. Whoever knows that.
There's boots in there. Boots are everywhere.
There's PBRs everywhere.
Button up denim shirts.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, no. Still a banger.
Still a banger. It is a banger.
Bunch of niggas with their elbow in the bar doing that. Trying to get the waiter's attention.
Like, excuse me, sir?
Bartender's attention.
And then on the other side of the spectrum. New Cupid.
So much soul. So black. This is unfair. I was genetically made to enjoy this.
That's true.
And I say no.
I see the green grass. I see the smoke from the grill.
Oh, yeah.
And I see a bunch of black people.
I see middle school in the gym during the dance that no girl wanted to dance with me with, but nobody could say no to doing the Cupid Shuffle with me.
You gotta do that.
You gotta do that one. I'll go first, okay, and then that way you guys can decide.
Okay.
I'm picking Achy Breaky Heart.
Yeah.
That is just so iconic. Like, Cupid Shuffle is a... I think it's gonna be timeless. Like, I think you can play that song in 50 years, but you can play Achy Breaky Heart.
Yeah.
Forever. Yeah. And, like, it's like that one country song when like someone says, "Oh, I don't listen to country," and then you bump that and you're like
I heard that before. Yeah, I get this.
Yeah.
I'm that guy. I don't really listen to country. I'm not a big country music fan. It's a couple songs I like, but definitely Cupid Shuffle for me, because I would never type in Achy Breaky Heart to play. Not saying there's something wrong with it, but and not saying I'd be typing in Cupid Shuffle, but I would definitely go there before Achy Breaky Heart for me, so Cupid Shuffle.
For sure.
Today was the first time that I actually listened to the lyrics of Achy Breaky Heart at the beginning.
And it's cold,
so I'm going to go Achy Breaky Heart.
I think a lot of us would actually. I think we're older. So we hear what he's saying.
It's a little different now.
Did you not hear what Buddy on Cupid Shuffle said? He said, "I'm not a rapper." That's deep.
That's deep.
Yeah, when everyone thinks you a rapper.
I'm not a rapper.
Yeah, I hear it.
I'm a mogul.
We had an album called "We Rap." We don't rap.
Now we got one of the all stars here, in my opinion. What is love?
Oof.
Versus Take On Me.
Listen, what is love so hard?
What is love?
That shit hard. Don't
hurt me.
That movie just reminds me of Will Ferrell. Fucking
Roxbury.
Yup. And then Take On Me was one of those songs that like I when I was starting to like music like 11, 12, where I was like, damn, this song is wild. I think I was just tripped out about like the sound and the synth and all that. I've always been like a heavy synth guy, so that shit caught me.
I'm into that shit too, so
yeah, no, it's very satisfying to hear.
This is tough.
It's a tough one.
Because when what is love come on, that shit come saucy on. And smooth. What is love?
Let me see. What is
and
love?
And then that shit drop.
What is love? Baby, don't hurt me.
Oh, yeah.
Don't hurt me no more.
All I see is cocaine lines in Miami.
Miami lights.
Chest out.
White suits.
No more.
This was Miami. For the South Beach area.
That's just so hard. I guess I could say the same thing about the synth line here.
That shit hard.
But then, you know, the classic with the classic drum intro. Mm-hmm.
That's my favorite sound. That shit is
beautiful.
Sounds so internet-y. That's not even a word, but internet.
Internet-y.
It'll make you happy. Yeah. Make you want
do an aerobics class in the 80s.
And his voice is just so soothing, fits beautiful. The song hey, so well.
That should make me happy.
Yeah,
that
yeah. Shit beautiful. All right, Cam, you can go first. Since
I'm gonna take on me, man. Yeah. It just makes me happy. What is love is fire. Like, yeah. You can't go wrong with that. But that take on me just makes me happy.
Yeah,
makes
no, me smile. Take on me is very happy. Go ahead, Rome. You got this. I'm still undecided, but I think I know where I'm going. Rome.
I'm a fan of really minor chords, man. So I'm gonna go with what is love. Yeah. I like it a little bit.
Like
yeah, it just it feels yeah, and yeah. I think I'm gonna go with what is love. Just, yeah.
As much as I love what is love, mm-hmm. It's a banger. That song I probably will play. Like that's probably the second song I would play the most out of this entire bracket mm-hmm. because it's just a banger. But Take on Me is. So important. I mean, it's so important to like the way I just love that one so much.
It reminds me of commercials too.
Take on Me? Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah,
mm-hmm. That's so I'm not mad at it. Yeah.
That's good. All right. The next two up, we got what I like to consider PE songs. Like songs that would play in PE to distract you, you know, while you're playing dodgeball or some shit. We got Gonna Make You Sweat, better known as Everybody Dance Now. Mm-hmm. And then Kung Fu Fighting.
Okay.
Everybody was Kung Fu Fighting. One song.
That intro to Kung Fu Fighting. When he come, whoa. And that in the and that sound in the back. Yeah. This shit's incredible.
No, that shit is incredible.
Without looking up, can you even tell me who sings this?
Can't remember.
This guy named Carl Douglas.
Carl Douglas.
Everybody was kung fu fighting.
That's why I was gonna walk down past my bro. Fast as lightning.
In fact, it was a little bit frightening. But they fought with expert timing.
There were funky Chinamen. That boy's singing.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, that flute?
Yeah, that shit hard.
That shit hard.
Man.
That shit hard.
And then it's a poser.
Everybody dance now. Everybody dance now.
Now this is what I that's like. I hear heart. I hear like a trailer for like a '90s show or something for that.
That shit hurts a lot of yeah. sounds.
There's
in there
a lot
too.
Of sounds. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, Rome. You go first. You into the kung fu fighting aspect or the dancing aspect?
He was singing.
He was.
He was singing.
Carl Douglas versus CC Music Factory.
What that first verse sound like on Everybody Dance Now?
Everybody yeah. Dance Now?
Face pajamas live in effect and I don't waste time. On the mic with a dope rhyme. Jump to the rhythm, jump, jump to the rhythm, jump. And I'm here to combine beats and lyrics to make you shake your pants, take a chance. Come on and dance, God.
I'm probably gonna make you sweat. Everybody dance now. It just yeah. it feels a little. I love Kung Fu Fight, but that one just feels.
You like that Vanilla Ice lyrical style?
Yeah, it's just,
I'm picking Kung Fu Fighting. That okay. shit. That he was singing.
He was singing. He was definitely singing.
I just can't stand that Everybody Dance Now song. I gotta admit that shit. That shit just. I can't get the image of my PE teacher playing that shit it's every iconic. Friday. Because she didn't want to fucking like yell at us. She's like, I'm gonna play this and play dodgeball. I'm like, mm-hmm. So I can't. So I'm going with Kung Fu Fighting.
I'm gonna go with Kung Fu Fighting.
Kung Fu Fighting. Mm-hmm. What was your reasoning?
I just prefer that song more than Everybody Dance Now. Everybody Dance Now is cool, but I would play Kung Fu Fighting way more than that.
You know, I'm trying to think, like, out of the songs we played, which one have I like played recently?
Yeah. Have you played any of these?
I don't think I played any of these recently.
I think
the next bracket, yes.
Yes. This next bracket. This next bracket.
Next two brackets.
Go ahead. I'll go ahead and introduce those two.
Oh, me? Yeah, okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, he got Sir Mix-a-Lot, Baby Got Back, and he got the infamous Cisco, Blonde, Platinum Hair.
You ain't shit for that. No. You ain't shit.
I had to get the booty songs together.
Here's the thing, like, they both have meaning, too. Like, I remember seeing Baby Got Back and rapping that as a kid, but I remember Thong Song. I was in, like, summer camp, middle school or something. I didn't even necessarily know what a thong was, but I just remember how big that song was in Miami, and then figuring out what thongs were, and it's like the video, and that shit was a smash, and I love that song, and I love that video.
So, have you seen that video of how he made that song?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, phenomenal. I love it. Oh, yeah. That he couldn't get the sample, so he got a violin player to...
That violin?
That violin is incredible.
I gotta hear that violin.
This song is incredible.
That shit is beautiful.
He's letting all the ladies know what guys talk about. You know, the finer things in life. Check it out. Ooh, that dress so scandalous. And you know another nigga can't handle it. So you're shaking that thing like who's the ish? With a look in your eyes so devilish. You like to dance on the hip hop spots. And you cruise to the cruise like an acrobat. Not just urban, she liked the pop. Cause she was living la vida loca. She had dumps like a truck, truck, truck. Eyes like what, what, what? Baby, move your butt, butt, butt. I'm gonna sing it again. She had dumps like a truck, truck, truck. Guys like what, what, what? All night long. Let me see that thong.
That shit's like...
You know how many girls I got to see they thongs that summer?
Man, that's iconic right there.
And it was show. I was excited, like, middle school kid at the start of my jacking off career.
Jacking off
and
career.
Now we know y'all gonna say it's not a one hit wonder. I get it. But that's his biggest song.
That's like, his biggest song.
Like, we not going.
The other song is a Drew Hill song.
We debated on adding this because we know he got more
we
songs.
Get it.
But this was, it's so big it feel like a one hit wonder. So
white people know this song.
I mean, yeah,
that's how
everybody know this song.
Yeah, yeah.
And then we got It's Competition.
Oh my God,
with this iconic intro.
Yeah. It's iconic. It is so big. She looks like a little bit. Who cares? She looks like a total prostitute.
Okay? He had a huge butt in the video, like prop. Like, that's so amazing. He was standing on a butt.
On a butt.
That's incredible.
Iconic. It's out there. I mean,
especially for back then.
Gross. Look.
And then it just comes in.
I like big butts and I cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny. When a girl walks in with an itty bitty waist and around thinking your face, you get sprung. Wanna pull up tough because you know that butt was stuck. Even the jeans she's wearing, I'm hooked and I can't stop staring. Oh baby, I wanna get whipped up and take your picture. My homeboy tried to warn me, but that butt you got
make me so horny.
Ooh, rough, rough, smooth skin. That's funny.
The only issue I have with this song, with Baby Got Back, it has this thing, I don't know how to word it, but it has this, like, the Shrek effect where I could hear it in Shrek. Like, if it was in the movie Shrek, I'd be like, yeah, I can see that. Thong Song would never be on there.
No.
And that...
Unless it's a very specific joke.
Yeah.
Very, like, yeah, exactly. Like, I don't know, I can't think
Here's
of it.
Here's the thing, though. I think it's this... Baby Got Back could have went far in this bracket. It just went up against a monster.
It went up against a monster.
It's a monster that a lot of things
could be. Against another booty track.
I feel you. But I'm just saying that's the reason why
we all know
it got to get out of here.
We got to go with Thong Song.
Not because it ain't worthy. It's just,
he was unfortunate. It's like people who played the Bulls in the 90s.
Yo. Yeah, like Karl Malone, U2 Jazz, they were incredible, but they just went against a monster.
Yeah, can't do nothing about it.
That's funny you guys bring that up, because I was watching the first episode of Last Dance. Mm-hmm. I watched the whole thing already, but I was just feeling I was feeling watching it again. And the first episode is talking about how Karl Malone and John Stockton were like the best, but they just couldn't do it.
Yeah,
I know. That's basically what this is. Jordan versus... the Jazz, but
because he rapped about the ass, Cisco rapped about what's in the ass. Mm-hmm.
I know my pick for the next one, but I love both songs. But
absolutely.
All right, let's see. You can go ahead first for the because you know which one
I went
you
want. First, you want.
Yeah. Okay. Jump Around both of these songs, we used to do them in our Dormtainment intro for our show.
Jump Around and Jump?
And Jump. And mm-hmm. I perform Jump.
Mm-hmm.
And Jump is just so hard to me. Jump Around is good, but mm-hmm. the rap and the beat that Jermaine Dupri did yep. is just it's iconic. So and I already know I'm going with Jump, but I like both of these songs.
In Jump, there's a diss like to, what's that other band? We're Not Some Cool Little Fat. Here, I'm going to play it because Another Bad Little Fat. What's it called?
Yeah.
Like the first line's a diss to someone else.
And another good, like when the beat come on, it's just,
just feel you, you feel it.
Come on now.
I think it's pretty.
Jump Around is good, but Jump mm-hmm. different.
I definitely went to elementary with my jeans backwards before plenty of times because I loved
really?
Them.
Yeah, damn, I loved them. I wonder if I could bring that back. Maybe not me, but you know, us, the collective me.
The collective me.
I don't really have the urge to do it, but I mean,
it's a possibility.
I think
at my big age, I've ran past that trend.
Nah,
Someone younger had to do it.
I think I could pull it off.
You might be able to do it.
Yeah. Sweater backwards, hood forward.
You can try.
Try to hide my face. All right. Next up, we got the M's, the little Latin flavor, I guess you could say. We got Mambo Number 5 versus Macarena.
Macarena was huge in Miami, with a huge Hispanic population. Yes. So I just grew up on that. Like,
do you remember the dance?
Oh yeah.
No.
As soon as you put it on.
And then Mambo Number 5. I was telling Rome, like I wasn't too familiar with the beat.
Like, to the liquor store around the corner, the boys say they want some gin and juice, but I really don't wanna be a buzz like I had last week. I must stay deep, cause talk is cheap. I like Angela,
you see what I'm saying?
Anna,
yeah.
Sandra, and Rita. And as I continue, you know they're getting sweeter. So what can I do? I really beg you, my lord.
To me,
learning is just like a sport. Anything fly, it's all good. Let me definitely sing in the trumpet. A little bit of Monica in my life, a little bit of Erica by my side, a little bit of Rita's all I need.
Shaniqua, what's that Freak of Leak song?
This
is the original Freak of Leak.
Yeah, it's original Freak of Leak.
And then Macarena.
That shit hard.
Macarena tiene un novio que se llama de apellido Vitorino. En la jura de bandera del muchacho. Macarena tiene un novio que se llama de apellido Vitorino. Y en la jura de bandera del muchacho. Se la dio con dos amigos. Dale a tu cuerpo alegría, Macarena, que tu cuerpo es para dar la alegría y cosa buena. Dale a tu cuerpo alegría, Macarena. Macarena.
We feeling Macarena?
Look, Macarena had the dance to go with it. But now hearing it back, it's been so long.
Hearing it back,
the mambo
different.
Hit a little hard
it
for
did.
Me.
It
like, I'd rather
did.
Listen to that than Macarena.
Yeah, the mambo hit a little hard. I was going to say.
You feeling the mambo?
Yeah, I was feeling the mambo.
I'm going to mambo.
Feeling the mambo? All right.
Yeah.
Mambo Number 5. You beat the Macarena. Here's one. Okay. This next two.
This is easy.
It's
definitely easy, but.
Can you explain the impact of this song, then?
Well, swag surfing in the black community, especially in the South, it's just like almost a Negro spiritual at this moment.
And the build-up in the beginning of the song is perfect.
You got to do it. And then Party All the Time, I'm assuming that's Eddie Murphy.
Yes.
Favorite comedian. I love him, and I love this song. He made it with Rick James, which is just crazy.
I remember that story.
And so I love both of these songs, but if I'm being honest, like swag surfing.
It's different.
It's different.
Yeah.
I'm gonna. We'll advance that one. We'll play in the next round.
Yeah, that's cool.
Swag Surfing is a pretty iconic for me too. I think I just remember. You know what it is? This is like around the time YouTube started with when this song was like popping, mm-hmm. and I remember I saw a video of people like doing it. Yeah, do it, yeah. And I was like, I'll never that be that. Crazy. I'll never be that cool.
Mm-hmm. Like, it's crazy. We've been to parties where it's just
definitely
been
that cool. I lead it.
Yeah, I gotta get in there.
You ever led one like on stage or something? Yeah.
Well, at every party I'm at, because I'll show you footage. Just tell me to show you footage when we're done. But this next one's going to be hard.
All right, this next one. Rome.
This
Rome,
definitely going
to
be hard.
Go ahead. I'm going to have you introduce this to Rome.
Shit, man. Go for it. All right, so we got Mark Morrison, Return of the Mac. This story, what a lot of people don't know is, of course, he's talking about returning as a Mac back to the streets, back to, you know, basically getting back in the streets.
City boys.
But he basically is referring to him getting out of jail. Mm-hmm. He was in jail. He got out of jail. It's Return of the Mac in that aspect. He's not even really supposed to be talking about a girl. He just used a girl to make the song
like life.
So that's a cool ass aspect. But then you got Montel Jordan. This is how we. It's not a party.
Great intro.
It is.
This is how we do it.
It's not a party that don't.
If
man.
It doesn't play, it's not a party.
It's not like that's a party. I'm talking about worldwide.
Also, Return to Mac, when they played it in Entourage, that shit is one of my favorite episodes. Like, they zooming into Mexico on the beach with Vince, and they playing that shit. Because they were trying to convince him to come back, because he is the Mac of that show.
So you just gotta play it, man.
All right. I'm gonna play like 10, 15 seconds of each one just to catch the feeling. All right.
This is my childhood.
That shit made me feel like
that shit on the radio. Like, come on. Oh! Hey. When we go back to Greece, we gotta play this. Yeah. We back, y'all.
Return of the Mac. Hey, that shit's saucy, man. I mean, Burger King did make a whole campaign off of Return of the Mac.
That
shit's
crazy.
That shit's
so funny.
This shit too.
This shit crazy too. Yeah. Get it skip like to 11 seconds.
This is how we do it.
This is how we do it. La, la, la,
la. Man, and ain't that slick Rick sample?
I literally was just thinking that.
Can you hear me?
This is how we do it.
That's what a man used to
do. This is how we do it. It's Friday night, and I feel all right. The party's here on the west side.
I think before we played it, This Is How We Do It was like the one that I was going with, but Return of the Mac.
Return of the Mac is hard.
Hit way harder.
It really, hit hard when we just played it back to back. I'm not going to lie, because This Is How We Do It, I was like, damn, this is going to be tough. But when you just play, I was like, Return Mac, it feels.
I think also, you guys know Talking Heads, my favorite band of all time. They broke up. Talking Heads, my favorite band of all time. They broke up for a little bit, and the drummer and the bass player made a side band called Tom Tom Club. They made a song called Genius of Love. This song samples that song. Damn. So
it's connected to you a
little
bit more.
My music brain is...
Yeah.
But yes, it's that much more special to me. So that's why I think I'm picking Return of the Mac.
Yeah, Return of the Mac.
I'm
going Return of the Mac.
Return of the Mac.
Because I can't. That shit, when it came on, I was like, that shit
hit fire.
I'm mad at it.
Now we got two poppy songs. We got I'm Blue, Dabba Dee Dabba Da.
Yeah, yeah.
And Barbie Girl. Hey,
that's going to be.
Now, you know what? This as cheesy as I'm Blue is, the chords.
The chords is hard. The chords.
Yo, listen up. Here's the story about a little guy that lives in a blue world. And all day and all night, and everything he sees is just
also
blue.
Minor.
Like him inside and outside. Blue his house with a blue little window and a blue Corvette. And everything is blue for him and himself and everybody around. Cause he ain't got nobody to listen to. I'm blue,
I've been dying, I've been dying, I've been dying. That's a wild to be a joke.
joke.
That's a wild hook.
Like, that had to be a joke.
I'm blue, wobble dee da woo da.
That's like messing with him, dog. Diggy do, diggy do.
Him and you could. You could.
Dog, diggy do.
That's the remix version.
That's the remix.
Watch that be a fucking hit.
Him and dog, diggy do. Him and dog, diggy do. Noggy, diggy do. But it's catchy as fuck. That's the bad part. It's catchy as fuck.
And then there's, so the thing about Barbie Girl is there's this video in a course I took in college that's basically gives you the outline.
You went to college?
I went to college. I went to college and got a degree. do I use it? No, but I got it. I had a class, and one of the courses was basically the structure of pop songs.
Yeah.
And yeah. Pop songs all like, the biggest example they had was Baby Hit Me One More Time, and we talked about how that song is fire, but they all have like a certain structure with like the chords they use, the bridge structure, mm-hmm. like all that. Barbie Girl is literally the perfect like
carbon copy.
And I don't know about you guys, but that shit hard.
I like Barbie Girl.
You wanna go for a ride?
Sure, Ken.
Jump in.
I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world. Life in plastic, it's fantastic. You can brush my hair, undress me everywhere. Imagination, life is your creation.
Come on, Barbie, let's go party.
I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world. Life in plastic.
This shit would go off drunk at a Vegas pool party.
Oh, yeah.
Like, if I'm drunk, this shit came on it.
It's
fantastic.
Yeah, this shit is ahead of its time.
It's Barbie Girl.
It's Barbie Girl.
Like, I'm never going to play on blue, to be honest. Yeah. Like,
it's funny.
It is what it is, but I ain't never playing.
Barbie Girl is a great bump, like, to bump, because when you're just, like, in a good mood, you're like, fuck you. Exactly, like a party song. All right, now we're going a little bit 90s, a little bit nostalgic. Do you remember these two songs, How Bizarre and Unbelievable?
I need to hear them.
Yeah, I think.
So How Bizarre is this one.
Oh, yeah.
That guitar. That nigga was on an island when he made it.
Oh, yeah,
he's an island boy.
On the back, sweet singers on the front. Cruising down the freeway in the hot, hot sun. Suddenly red blue lights flash out from behind.
This is summer. Yeah, this is
loud
summer.
Voice booming, please.
On the PCH.
Step out to the line. Ballet bridge was a comfort. Cena just hides
her
eyes.
Or a little kid riding a bike through a neighborhood.
Sell a Chevy 69. How bizarre.
But it's Venice. Neighborhood. Yeah. You're close to the beach.
I think the song's about like drug dealing.
That's funny. That's,
which Makes is like sense. Even better.
Which is
like,
high in the summer.
Yeah. High in the summer. And then Unbelievable. Another like trailer song.
Unbelievable.
You say.
Unbelievable. This one's tough because two songs I really don't care about.
Yeah, it is. But yeah. Which one's like, do you feel more? It's funny. It's one, the How Bizarre is by OMC, Unbelievable is by EMF. That's I didn't even funny. Know that they were acronym names. I mean, I'm not entirely too, like, I don't bump these songs either.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But I think the How Bizarre, like, guitar.
Definitely more of my vibe. Yeah. But Unbelievable was bigger, was it?
Yeah, I mean, that song, like, people just know that part.
It's unbelievable.
There's also, like, a commercial. I can't remember which candy bar, but they're like, it's Crumbelievable, and that's where
it's Crumbelievable.
Yeah, if you know what I'm talking about, comment it down below. I know that's the commercial for some.
I guess, guitar-wise, I think I'm just going with How Bizarre. It just felt better.
It felt nice. I liked How Bizarre a little bit. How Bizarre.
Mm-hmm.
All right, now, the next two are, earlier I said.
I see
his
thumb thugging.
Yeah, I was about to say thumb thugging. I'm about to say, all right, let's do it.
Thug, thubbing. No. Tub Thumping and All Star. Now, these are the equivalent of what I said earlier, Shrek ass songs. Yeah, yeah. Do you know which one Tub Thumping is?
I need to hear them. Like, as soon as I hear it, I know I'm going to know.
Give it a second. Maybe you'll not. No, you'll know in a minute.
Yeah, I know. As soon as I hear it.
This is just the intro.
I do like them chords.
Truth is, I thought it mattered.
That's how you know I don't play this song. Mattered. I don't know what this is.
No, nah, it changes up.
Not compared to how people matter.
You'll know it.
I get no
gotcha. I know that.
Is this Green Day?
No.
Who the
Chumbawamba?
What?
Chumbawamba.
Chumbawamba. Okay, yeah. That's a big switch up.
That's a big switch up.
I know All Star.
Yeah, of course.
Somebody
yeah, that's
told me.
Yeah, that's the winner.
That's that shit right there.
That's that shit. That knockdown song though, that's like another like '90s staple. Like that shit was probably in so many like trailers or movies too. Yeah. But All Star is undefeated.
I know the winner of this next one, but these are both great songs.
Okay, okay. You know what? Let's have the Bahamian talk about it.
Okay.
Let's hear what you got to say about.
I mean, of course, you know, it was from Baja Men Who Let the Dogs Out. Yeah. It's a huge stadium song. That's where you really hear it in stadiums. And then Eye of the Tiger. That's iconic, though, man. Like, play it.
Eye of the Tiger
right quick.
That shit is iconic.
Ooh, oh, shit. I didn't add it on here. Let me find it.
All right, here we go.
Here we go, Mike. There we go.
Oh.
We going to deduct some pay. That shit is. I just think movies.
Yo.
I even like when you come on singing.
Yeah, as I said, we know the winner of this, but Who Let the Dogs Out is iconic. Eye of the Tiger, crazy.
Yeah.
Now this one,
oh, okay.
This is one of my favorite one-hit wonders.
Which one? The Don't Worry?
What? That shit go the fuck off. Somebody I used to know fire too, but Don't Worry, man. That shit feels a.
That shit.
You ever seen the video for this?
Nah, I'll check it out.
It's a cool video. It's great so message. It feels great.
Indeed, indeed, indeed. He's getting his Timberland on.
Oh, yeah.
Here's a little song I wrote.
Come on, man.
I want to sing it note for note. Don't worry. Be happy. In every life we have some trouble.
I think, yeah, that one's
when
very
drop into that shit.
Very, very pleasing to hear. The one thing I do like about Somebody I Used to Know is that the lyrics are just so clear.
Oh yeah, no,
like
yeah.
There's no like, you know, I love a simile.
Yeah, yeah.
I love a metaphor here and there, but just so clearly wrote what
this song was a smash. This is crazy. Great song.
Together, like when you said you felt so happy you could die. I told myself that you were right for me, but felt so lonely in your company. But that was love and it's an ache I still remember.
And then the little that part. So,
video's crazy too.
Yeah, yeah. What I also heard about Gotye is that he doesn't like license. He lets anybody use it like for a short film or like whatever, as long as it's not like a major production. He's like anybody could use this song. Like
that's good. That's cool.
So I give him respect.
So they better not flag us when we put this on YouTube. Gotye.
Gautier.
Clone sounding name. Yeah,
but all right, I'll go first, and then you guys can make the decision for the two. I am personally going to go with somebody I used to know, just because I like feel like I love the "Don't Worry, Be Happy." Mm-hmm. It's a great uplifting song. I probably would listen to that more, but somebody I used to know, you know, might be personal reasons, but that song I just go to a lot more. So. Romus.
I'm going somebody I used to know. Yeah. Overall, the music hits harder for me. The chords are better. The overall structure of that song is just fire. Don't Worry is a simple song, and I do like it, but somebody used to know. When it gets deeper into the song and he starts singing, that shit
hit for me. Don't Worry, because I'm optimistic and I'm positive. Yep.
I'm sitting That's what between we love two about pessimists.
They don't want to be happy. They want to worry.
They want to worry. I want to be stressed all the time. That's how I work.
They want to do worry, be sad. Thinking about somebody they used to
do
know.
Worry, be
I'm past
sad.
My past. My past don't define me.
We got two funky like little tracks here. We got
Funky Town,
and play crazy. That funky music, white
this
boy.
This is a good battle.
So
I think I know where I'm leaning, but maybe once I hear it.
Once you're all right, so let's go with Funky Town. Let's hear.
That shit crazy.
Ooh.
I need to hear the funky sound before I leave. And even if you want to skip through it.
Anyway. Ooh, that bridge. Mmm.
There it comes.
That chord change is nice. Ooh, that's it. That shit hard.
Them hips are rocking.
Oh, damn. That's hard.
That is hard. I forgot about that part.
Yeah, that violin.
That's crazy, man. It got auto-tune and go to another when she's singing.
Yeah, that little lasers sound.
Switch chords. Shit, that's crazy. Hard.
Let's hear it's a other one.
Man, that's
iconic. My mom loves this song.
This song reminds me of an Undercover Brother.
Oh, yeah.
It reminds me of Superbad, as every movie like that.
Get to the chorus. That shit, like I said, those are like a more like Funky Town is like a synth kind of dreamy song that I would like. I could probably learn to play that, and then Funky Music is like a movie song.
Yeah.
Like I would hear that in movies.
Yeah.
Which do I enjoy like listening to more? I kind of think Funky Town hit a little harder for me.
I'm going with Funky Town.
You think Funky Town?
Like,
I think Funky Town.
Play that funky music, fire.
Yeah. But I'm going with Funky Town.
Funky Town, that shit.
Just so, it hit different. That bridge part before the,
that
shit.
Hard.
I'm going to listen to that on the way home. Just fucking bump that.
I fucking love Stacey's mom.
Stacey's mom was so catchy to me.
So catchy.
So
Stacey's
catchy.
Mom has got it going on.
I had a neighbor.
So easy.
I had a neighbor whose mom was super hot, but the mom's name was Stacey. So it was like just a missed opportunity.
I mean, damn.
But, and then Kiss Me is like, every romantic comedy had to have it or else it didn't work.
Mm-hmm. I need to hear that again because this is the name. I'm trying to remember what it is. Oh, yeah.
Every white teenage
picture a girl.
Can't hardly wait and all this.
A girl walking down the stairs dressed in nice clothes.
Coming down. That's her transformation. She was a nerd. Now they got her looking good.
They took off her disgusting glasses.
Like Clueless or some shit.
Those fucking ugly ponytails.
Then they, in slow motion, they smile, they do a twirl, put one leg up. Yeah. And then the guy's looking.
Like, no, they all stand up. Like,
they all look. Oh, she took off her glasses.
She never let her hair down.
One of the first songs I learned how to play on guitar.
Beneath a Milky Twilight.
But.
Stacey's mom, different.
It just make you happy. It's the memory.
It's such a good fucking. Dun, 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 dun.
Stacey's mom has got it going on. Stacey's mom has got it going on. Stacey's mom has got it going on.
We all done seen a hot mom before.
Huh?
We all done seen a hot mom before.
Yeah.
Stacey, can I come over after school? After school, we can hang around by the pool. Did your mom get back from her business trip?
That's such a fire.
That's funny. That's funny.
Is she there, or is she trying to give me the slip? No, I'm not the little boy that I used to be. I'm all grown up now, baby, can't you see? Stacey's mom has got it going on. She's all I want and I've waited for so long. Stacey, can't you see? You're just not the girl for me. I know it might be wrong, but I'm in love with Stacey's mom.
I think Stacey's mom got to take that. That song is just so fire. Like certain chords just get you going.
Yeah,
and that's the one.
Was Hey There Delilah one hit? Guys, I love that song.
You
Hey
know,
There Delilah.
Yes, I think they have one other hit that I can't fucking think of. Hmm. But Plain White Tees. You know the story about that song about Hey There Delilah. So Hey There Delilah was a girl he met. Like he met her one day, and he's like, I'm going to write a song about you and it's going to be big. And she's like, all right, whatever. And like, he wasn't in a relationship with her, like nothing. She had a boyfriend and he wrote the song about her. It got big and she tried to get money off of it.
She tried to get money off of it.
Did it work?
Nope. They straight up were like, no. Like,
yeah. What, like, how are you going to get money off of it?
Why? What? Well,
anybody
can
be named Delilah.
Yeah. But like, I guess because she's like, no, but that's about me. He's like, yeah, I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, yeah, you didn't be with me, so you
know. Okay. No, they like, I think she tried to like come back and like ask the singer, is like, hey, like, can I get some money off of that?
Nope.
And he's just like, the fuck out of here.
Yeah, nope. Yeah.
You didn't even believe. Maybe if you believed,
maybe. You should have listened to Journey.
Then she stopped.
Yeah.
But don't. All right.
Here we go.
Now we're going to the Sweet 16 round.
Let's do it.
We got two of the iconic white boys in music right here. We got Ice Ice Baby.
We know what's
Achy Breaky Heart.
We know what's winning.
What was you going? Ice
Ice Baby. Come on.
Ice Ice is nice.
Ice Ice is nice.
Yeah. Now,
there's an update on mine, or is it not supposed to?
What is it?
On the brackets on my computer, but it don't matter. I can see.
All right, for sure. We got Kung Fu Fighting for the next one versus Take On Me. I think...
Play Take On Me again?
Take On Me.
They're all running together. Right there, number six.
Oh, shit.
gonna go with Take On Me.
Yeah.
Take On Me is just
it hit.
It's so fire. Like, I can't get over that synth. Take On Me. Watch Take On Me go farther. Oh wait, no, I just realized what's next.
I mean, you know,
all right, come all right. On, we're going. We're
that's
gonna,
going to the end.
Yeah, that's you know it's going to the end.
Thong song. I just am picturing that music video.
That shit's iconic.
He did not need those many tour buses. Let's be real.
It's just like, who's gonna compete against it? Because we know it's
and
going.
We know it is well.
All right.
We know it's about to compete against it.
Swag Surfing.
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
I think Swag Surfing's got a tough little break coming.
It definitely does.
All right. Return of the Mac, Barbie Girl.
Come on now.
You know, I'm going to say Barbie Girl, but I know where we're going.
Sure,
know
I think it. I know what the final two going to be.
All right. Now, these two is a weird combo because
All-Star.
Stop it.
I wish you for
all right. Eye of the Tiger, Somebody I Used to Know. Somebody I Used to Know for me is still a little bit more.
But we
iconic.
Know
it's Eye of the Tiger.
Eye of the Tiger.
Okay.
Yeah, it's Eye of the Tiger. And I love Somebody I Used to Know, but Eye of the Tiger crazy.
Off the Tiger. Eye of the Tiger. I can't spell. I don't care anymore. All right.
Funky Time.
You say Funky. I say Stacey's Mom.
I say Funky Time.
You say Funky Time?
I say Funky Time.
Damn. This sweet
that's a way better song, Stacey's Mom. Yeah. Stacey's Mom make you feel happy as nostalgic.
But like Funky Town crazy.
Hey, go Funky listen Town to every crazy. Break. That's
yeah, I guess
stupid.
You're right. I'll go take a listen to that one. All right.
Here we go.
That was a quick Sweet 16. Now we got
that's how you
gotta
get to it.
Elite 8.
Elite 8.
Ice Baby, Take On Me. Now, Ice Baby, iconic. We get it. Fucking just that hi-hat intro, yo VIP. The flat top white boy with the lines in his hair.
Let me just throw my hat in, even though I ain't got a hat. I'm going with Ice Baby, so y'all got to battle.
I'm going with Take On Me because as much of an iconic song Ice Baby is, Take On Me left more of an impact for me. Like, I love rap, but I think I'm more a like pop kind of guy, like synth pop kind of guy. So Take On Me.
Ice Baby.
Damn it. Yeah. I did you. I couldn't do it. Uh-huh.
I'm Take On Me hard. It made it to the Elite 8.
It did. Yeah. I would say that was like a game point winner.
Now you got to play Swag Surfer.
Swag Surfer.
I mean, I know Cam, but I just I got to hear it. Because that shit come on saucy. It do.
Man, I got this swag. My head back to my back. You know I'm popping tag.
You just know what's coming. You're like, yeah.
Man, I got this swag. Man, I got this swag. My head back to my back. You know I'm popping tag. But man, I got this swag. I swag when I surf. Now why be surfing swag? I'm on him. Not his polo.
I'm clean like this detergent.
This sound was my college life.
Oh yeah,
this is what you
like. This was a sound while I was in college.
That shit.
So
yeah, but we know. Just go ahead and hit thong song.
All right. I'm not even gonna ask.
Yeah, no, I mean,
don't even ask. Now, this one I can actually see a little debate. Eye of the Tiger and Funky Town.
Yeah, that's a debate. That's a debate.
I here's where we like talk about. What are we going off how the song makes us feel or how we feel the song?
I think you gotta do everything. You think you gotta do everything.
Right, let's hear real quick. Eye of the Tiger.
Honestly, I think it's Funky Town.
I think
it can compete in the final four.
But play Eye of the Tiger.
You think so?
Nah, it can't compete in the final four. It's good. It can't compete in the final four.
Here's Eye of the
Funky
Tiger.
Town has at least a shot. Look, it's a great mid. It's like it's a phenomenal song, but it's also mid.
It is mid.
Come on now. Stop
that. That shit's crazy.
Now, this shit ain't mid.
They got a lot of shit going on.
Nah, that's elite. That's elite. All right.
Here we go.
All right. Ice Ice Baby and Thong Song.
Come on,
now,
man.
You got to put hold on. Put aside your person. For no, this
it's not
man.
Even.
They both got personal both reasons.
Yeah, yeah.
For me,
and like, it's not even personal now. That violin is one of my favorite violins in music history.
Thong Song is crazy.
His Thong Song is crazy.
I'm going with Thong Song. Just
I gotta go Thong Song.
Like I dyed my hair white because of fucking Cisco. Because
look, I love Ice Ice Baby, yes. But after the first verse, I'm good. Yeah. I'm good.
Beginning of Thong Song.
The beginning
of Ice Ice Baby. I know, but this is.
That shit is all the ladies beautiful.
What guys talk about? You know. Finer things in life.
Beautiful.
Check it out. Ooh, that dress so scandalous. And you know another nigga can't handle it. So you're shaking that thing like who's the ish with the look in the
eyes. All right, stop it. Stop it. Because we're going to have to play it next round because we know what it's about to go against.
Yes. Now, I think it's got
to
be.
You know what it's about to go against because this makes sense.
Yeah, man.
Now, Return on, of the Mac. And
come
Funky
on, stop,
Town.
Stop.
You, Mike, don't Mike, dig stop. Stop, Mike.
I'm sorry. I'm trying to make a competition here.
God, we go get to the competition. All right, all right. We ain't going to waste our time.
Here, I'm going to play Return. All right, so we got Return of the Mac.
Now, this is where it's going to get sticky for me. All right, because.
Yeah. I got to put my computer down for this.
It's where it gets fucking sticky.
Oh, that shit.
Nigga, I'm in Greece. My shirt opened up. The wind blowing.
You know,
man, y'all niggas
finna go meet some girls
I'm back
at the bar
in Meeking
real quick.
Town, nigga.
I'm back. Oh, yeah. Come on.
I'm on. Oh, yeah. My God, I'm tired of your
hey.
But I guess you never know. As I said, the story told.
Yeah.
Baby, now I got the flow. Cause I know it from the start. Baby, when you broke my heart, that I had it all my day.
Yeah.
I'm sure you that
what
I
what'd you do, Mark?
You lied to me.
Woo!
All those times I said that I love you. You lied to me.
Yeah.
Yes, I tried. Yes, I tried.
Yeah.
You lied to me. Even though you knew I'd die for you. You lied
yeah.
to me. Yes, I cried.
Look, you best do it during the bar. That's tough to beat. That
Whoa.
Shit crazy.
Whoa.
But you gotta remember.
Yeah. Woo, that shit come on saucy.
All the ladies know what guys talk about.
And you know we love a good thong
you
around
know,
here.
We love a good thong.
A good thong. Talk that shit, Cisco.
Check it out. That dress is scandalous, and you know another nigga couldn't handle it. So you're shaking that thing like who's the ish with the look in your eyes so devilish. You like to dance on the hip hop spots, and you cruise to the cruise like connect the dots. Not just urban, she liked the pop, cause she was living la vida loca.
She had
dumps like a truck, whoa. truck, thighs like what? Baby, move your butt, I'm gonna sing it again. She had dumps like a truck, thighs like what? All night long. Let me see that thong. Baby, that thong, thong. I like it when the beat go. Baby, make your booty go. That thong, thong.
All right. Play Return again right quick.
Return of the Mac. I'll skip forward a little bit too.
No, I want to hear that top. I need
beginning?
That top, yeah. All right.
Let's see.
I think I'm going with Mark, man.
That shit crazy.
It give you a feeling.
It do.
I'm sorry to do this, Serum, but I'm going Thong Song. So.
Hey, Roll, stop the music.
I'm going Thong Song.
And whatever he need to make his decision, we got to abide to.
Yeah.
So I'm going with Mark Morrison, Return of the Mac. And that shit got me feeling.
Let me hear second verse
of
Thong Song and Mark Morrison. Right, Let me hear second verse of both.
While I sing my comeback song, on this beam you said, hold on, return of the moon.
This Don Toliver daddy.
Oh, here we go.
Here I go, return of the moon, a little girl, return of the moon.
That breakdown.
Stop lying about your good break.
Your lies are mine. She said she'd never turn on me. Your lies.
Mark.
You, Mark?
I don't need to hear it.
You don't even want to hear a thong song.
I don't need to hear it.
Wait, you didn't even hear the verse.
I don't need it.
Let me hear it. Let me hear it.
But you can play it, but I don't need to hear it.
Fuck, I'm still going to try to convince
you. Play it. Play it. No, I'm talking about the...
Oh, it's just the thong song?
The thong song.
All right, Second verse, thong song.
I think I'm backing up. That is.
The breakdown at the end of the thong song.
This right here is hard.
Just right here.
In a beach, open shirt.
Yeah. You hear the violins? I ain't never heard a white sing about thong. Yeah. Talk that shit, Cisco.
Listen, said I like the way.
I don't think they heard you.
I don't think you heard.
That's it hard right there. Okay, I did need to hear that. I did
end of Return of Mac.
Return of the Mac.
Like towards the end of the song.
Let's see.
That shit tough. Oh, you got back it up a little bit.
Okay. Is there any breakdown?
I don't think it's a breakdown.
Nah, I think it fades out. I don't know. I don't see you guys up and singing the way you guys are singing.
No. Hold on. And you ain't had a volume all the way up. You cheating. All right, this is going to determine me one more time. Play thong song very beginning.
Thong song very
beginning.
You got to hear that.
And I need it loud. I need both. Very beginning loud. Give me like.
This thing right here.
Woo!
That shit fire.
Letting all the ladies know what guys talk about. You know, the finer things in life.
I can hear. Let me hear through the first verse. Let me just spill it.
Ooh, that dress so scandalous, and you know another nigga can handle it. So you're shaking that thing like who's the ish with the look in your eyes so devilish. You like to dance on the hip hop spots. Cruise to the cruise, to connect the dots. Not just her Ben, she liked the pop. Cause she was living la vida loca. She had dumps like a truck. Thighs like what? Baby, move your butt. I think I'll sing it again. She had dumps like a truck. Thighs like what? All night long. Let me see that thong. Baby.
I need to hear Mark from the beginning.
Mark from the beginning, all the way up. Just
through the foot.
That's tough.
I'm still feeling
that's tough.
Thong song hit me.
Thong
like,
song.
I don't know how to explain it, but there's like, you know, you just listen to music and you hear it a certain way and it makes you feel like good. Mm-hmm. Thong song just got me right there.
Mm-hmm.
This is how we do it. It's great. I mean, I'm sorry. Return of the Mac is great, but a thong song just, it got me. It got me I'm a loop.
Now, I agree. Thong Song is incredible. Like, that is one of my favorite songs, like, in this genre of songs. But that Return to Mac right now, I guess it's touching me right now where I am in my life.
Yeah.
Like, Thong Song, that was middle school, excited for that. It brings nostalgia. But, like, this is where I want to be, how I want to feel every day. I want to be out this country, in another country, on vacation, at the beach, my shirt open, wind hitting my chest, drinking passion fruit juices and eating fucking octopus, grilled octopus. That's the life I'm living right now.
I still think you can do all that with Thong Song. All
right, nah, it ain't the same hit. Here we go. Here we go.
What you got?
So, Return of the Mac.
I don't know why I haven't called you Robe Green.
Robe Green Jr.
Robe Green.
So, Return of the Mac. The meaning behind the song with this man struggling in jail and getting out, and saying he returning to the streets, and then flipping it to write it the way he did, and the beat and the feeling of that song is incredible.
I also gotta remember that video of Cisco making the Thong Song. It just makes you appreciate that
for
song
sure.
Way more for the struggle that he had.
But you don't know what went into making the Return of the Mac. First, he had to get out of prison.
Well, here's the thing. I don't know, but I do know the Thong Song story.
You do.
So
yeah.
That's why I feel like it's hitting me. I didn't know that about it until you said it right now.
So that's my piece on Return of the Mac. But Cisco Thong Song, after hearing it again.
I think I know the winner based on how he's setting it up.
We got him, ladies and gentlemen.
You got him.
Cisco, the third verse and all of that is just incredible. But I'm going with Mark Morrison.
Whoa! I didn't see that one coming, y'all.
I'm going with Mark.
Why
are
you going with Mark?
Why are you going with Mark?
It's exactly all the reasons Cam said, and then like when I picture that intro of Entourage, it feels good. And when I hear that song, I think I'm walking and nobody can touch me. That's what it feels like when Return of the Mac. That's just, I can't feel that with Thong Song. I feel ass for
mm-hmm.
sure,
mm-hmm.
and ass has won a lot of songs in these in these competitions.
Yep.
But this today, ass is gonna lose today.
Ask him second to you.
Ask him second to me.
As it should, I guess.
And here's the thing.
You over ass. Why away?
This was a great battle at the end because I didn't know it was going to come down to them two. I had a feeling.
I knew.
I had a feeling they was going to go strong, but I didn't know they was going to come down to there.
Yeah. I almost had you there, too.
You did. When you hit that third verse with that change, I was like, damn, this shit hard. But Return of the Mac, man.
Damn.
That's it.
Return of the Mac, the
Mark.
Winner.
Mark got him one.
Hey, coming out of jail. Got him a winner.
He spoke to the struggling artists out there.
Yeah. Which of these songs, I guess, would it be Return of the Mac that you're bumping first?
I don't know. I mean, it
depends how I feel, but most likely I'll probably play that more.
I think I'm coming
more
back to Stacey's Mom and Barbie Girl and... what's the other one? What is Love?
What is Love.
I'm about to play Funky Town.
Yeah, Funky
I'm
Town,
I need to see every drop, every decision they made.
Yeah,
it was
Funky
incredible.
Town,
yeah, that shit.
It deserved to be in the top four. All the songs in the top four deserve to be there.
Yeah, yeah. Ice Baby. I just, if you don't know the story about Vanilla Ice, the whole Suge Knight.
The balcony.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
That shit crazy.
Tell the story real quick.
Well, they hung him by his feet off a balcony to sign this contract. So you get that money, and if you were in that position, you probably would have signed it too to save your life. And
Suge Knight. Was it Suge Knight and his peoples?
That's wild. That's wild.
He's denied the story, but...
And it's funny how, like, one song can save a label, because, like, Warren G, Regulator, saved Def Jam.
Mm-hmm.
Def Jam was about to go bankrupt, and that song from the West Coast just took off, and they made enough money to stay alive.
I think there's another song that was like that.
I see Mark Morrison on Instagram.
Was he up to?
Yeah,
wearing big ass jeans.
Right now. Right
let's
now.
See. Let's see. Mark Morrison. Yeah, how you spell Morrison?
M O R R I S O or M I. One of them.
One of those.
M O R I S S O N or M O R R I S S O N.
Mark Morrison Official.
Which one was it? The last name.
M O R I S.
What's Mark Morrison up to these days?
Founder of Mac Life Records.
Oh, yes.
Mac Life.
Return of the Mac, 6 hours ago, Return of the Mac really is one of the best timeless songs ever. Mark Morrison didn't have to go that hard. This is perfect for this, how he won.
How many followers he got?
25,000. I should DM him and say, we just did a bracket song.
Yeah, he in L.A.? Tell him come on, come on, come on.
He got an LA highlight right here.
Hey, tell him come on, come on, come on.
Mark Morrison, if you're
out there. I'm about to hit him right now.
If you're out there and you watch this, Mark, I'm sorry I didn't pick your song, but I would love to have you on the podcast.
And it's the 25th anniversary.
Oh, shit.
Today.
If it's today.
November 10th.
Of this year?
Last year was the 25th.
Hey, it's close enough.
It's close enough.
Happy anniversary, Mark.
Mac love. Life. Look, come on, man. You return on Mac.
Tell him come on, Comic Truck.
We gotta get him on. All right. Well, that does it for the One Hit Wonders bracket. I think we did a good selection here. We got more brackets coming up, so don't worry. Watch our previous ones on Luda, Kanye, and Wayne. And if you have any other suggestions that you want to see us do, just comment those down below. We heard you. We heard Drake. We heard Jay-Z. We got it. We're waiting on those. All right. Those are iconic artists that you kind of have to give some time and break down. So until then, we'll catch you next time.
Peace.